Hey there, my name is John Suskovich. I'm the founder and creative director here at Farm Marketing Solutions, and I'm here to answer your questions. I got some AMA or Ask Me Anything questions into my inbox. Not every week I'm gonna be in this little sound booth confessional thing. I'll be out on the farm too, but today happens to be 13 degrees outside. I'm working outside. I'm with a camera trying to be like, oh yeah, and then this is what you do. And I also am not gonna be inside all the time because I can shoot stuff on the farm, and it's not always gonna be about chickens because I just get a lot of questions about chickens. But as you guys write in more and more, I will create more of these, and they will cover a diversity of topics all centered around sustainable agriculture. So our first question today to get today's episode about from converting lawn into pasture from Carlos Reyes, and again, sorry for names. I just moved to New England to a property that was once a farm many decades ago. The open areas look like just regular old lawn grass with some wild strawberry coverings. How do I turn existing lawn grass into good pasture fit for grazing? This is one of those times when I'm like, ooh, this is good. I got a good answer for this one, and it's gonna be easier than you think. So for me, regular old lawn grass, it means that things have been mowed and they're pretty tight and your fields are pretty even, but that doesn't mean there's only one type of grass there. The best way to see the grass, to experience your farm, is to get down on your belly and start looking at stuff. See how many different varieties of things you can actually identify in your grass. If you're in New England, which I'm in New England, I'm in Western Connecticut, you're gonna have a diversity in your lawn, even though everything looks green. When you're starting out, and I don't know what your background is, Carlos, so we'll just assume that you're starting out. You're starting out, field of green grass looks like a field of green grass. And when you have been doing it a number of years and you see the animals interact with the different species of grass, when you see what grows back quicker, what weeds you have, and you've identified some things, you'll start to realize that you have biodiversity built in. Unless you moved into a golf course where they really just had Kentucky bluegrass or whatever it is they grow on golf courses, you're gonna have some diversity. And to make it into pasture, you let it get a little rougher than you would with a lawn. You know, a lawn, if you're mowing it to 3 inches, is gonna be pretty stuck at 3 inches. And the more you mow it, the more shallow your root system is gonna be. If you start to let it go fallow a little bit, like an organized fallow, you'll start to see other weeds and diversity of different pastures come up. So to convert it, I mean, you could backseed with things that you actually want, but I would let it come up a little bit longer. I would take a closer look, get down on your belly and see what is there. If you want to convert your lawn into pasture, all it takes is letting it go, doing less work, and then running animals over it. So you know you get a spring mow in, grass is coming up, and then you're, all right, I have birds coming in a month, or they're a month before they're getting out onto the grass. Let it go, see how long it gets, see how much rainfall you get. Take notes, take pictures with your phone when you're out. Like, grab a cup of coffee in the morning or a beer in the evening, go out, take a stroll, and then look down what's at your feet. Not just from up here, but actually get down on your stomach and take a look at what you have going on. And you'll notice that there's bug life, that there's plant life, and there's all this little stuff going on. If you're low to no spray, if it was a farm back in the day, do some soil tests to see where your soils are at. The acidity of your soil and the composition of your soil are gonna dictate what weeds and grasses grow best on your farm. And if you want certain weeds or grasses or what forage to grow better, do that soil test, get those results back, do some research on what you would do to amend your soil to get it into an area that would harbor great grasses, and kind of go from there. This is a learning experience, it's something you gain over time. You're gonna run animals over it, they're gonna poop and spread seeds, you're gonna throw some hay down maybe on something to cover stuff up, you're gonna backseed it with some pasture mixes, and this place had a sale on this pasture mix, and this place had a sale on that pasture mix, and you decided to go with whatever. Turning lawn into grass is easy. You just give it time and throw your hands up and say, that's it, that's just, I'm gonna let it do its thing. I know there could be a more scientific question of like, specifically you would wanna do this and you're gonna want a pH balance about this and you're gonna see this many things, but without knowing your specific piece of property, the background, the history, the soil test, the soil composition, I don't know, you know, whatever your goals are for livestock, let the grass grow, let the animals eat it, keep an eye on it, learn, watch the YouTube channel here on Farm Marketing Solutions. Look for the Grass Whisperer section where we went over cattle grazing and what type of forage is good. How do you do soil tests? How do you do the forage tests and send those in? We'll be doing more of that stuff with Troy going forward in 2019. And then just subscribe to the channel and keep coming back for these Ask Me Anything. If you want to leave me a question, head on over to farmmarketingsolutions.com. Go to the bottom of the homepage and you will see a form where you can put your name, select your topic, and leave me a short question, and I'm going to answer it here on the short form video. The next one that I got is about perimeter fences from Chuck Lambert. Stay tuned, subscribe to that channel. Tomorrow is going to be perimeter fencing, and you're going to like that one. Oh yeah, bye.